and welcome to the Berks History Center's December 2016 monthly program on BCTV. My name is Sime Bertolet. I'm the Executive Director of the Berks History Center and your host for this show. Tonight I'm joined by Alexis Campbell, and Alexis is the PR, Marketing, and Advertising Director for the Berks History Center, and we also have a special guest who will be joining us later in the program, and that's Bradley K. Smith. Bradley's a longtime friend of the Berks History Center. He's a museum consultant. He's the guest curator for the exhibits you'll be seeing tonight, and he is also the collections management manager here at the Berks History Center. The Berks History Center is open Tuesday through Friday from 10 a.m. to 3 p.m. and on Saturday from 9 a.m. to 3 p.m. The Henry Janssen Library, located directly behind the Berks History Center, is open Wednesday through Friday from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. and on Saturday from 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. The Berks History Center is located at 940 Center Avenue, about a mile south of the First Energy Stadium on Center Avenue or Route 61. The Henry Janssen Library is located at 160 Spring Street, again, directly behind the Berks History Center.
You can help the Berks History Center and the Henry Janssen Library preserve the history of Berks County by becoming a member. Our memberships start at $35 for a primary membership and $55 for an individual and $65 for a family. Memberships include free admission to the museum and library, free admission to our exhibits, and four issues of our quarterly magazine, The Historical Review of Berks County, and that's for individual levels and higher. You can go online to join at berkshistory.org or by calling us at 610-375-4375 or by visiting us at 940 Center Avenue. Memberships always make a great gift, and another added benefit of a membership is that we get a 10% discount at our museum store. While you're visiting the Berks History Center and the Henry Janssen Library, remember to stop in and visit our museum store where we have all sorts of unique gifts that celebrate the unique history of Berks County. Gift certificates are also available.
Yeah, and they make a great Christmas gift too. That's all right. But while we're on the subject of membership, we talked about the membership to the Berks History Center, but another very important organization in Berks County that needs your support is what you're watching right now, BCTV. BCTV is an incredible community asset that we have here in Berks County. And if you like watching programs such as the Berks History Center program or any one of the many other programs that they provide that deal specifically with Berks County and your community, I ask that you support BCTV. You can support BCTV by sending your check to BCTV at 1900 North 13th Street, Reading, Pennsylvania, 19604. Make sure that this great program keeps coming to you every day.
Our next Second Saturday program at the Berks History Center is called Imprisonment, Trial, and Execution of the Lincoln Conspirators. It'll be presented by Mark Grimm, and this program is an educational overview of the conspirators who planned and carried out the assassination of President Abraham Lincoln, and that's on December 10th here at the Berks History Center. Our Henry Janssen Library Book Club meets on February 15th at 5:30 p.m. They will be discussing the most recent book that they read, which is The River of Doubt, Theodore Roosevelt's Darkest Journey. We also have some bus trips coming up with the Berks History Center. Our next bus trip is the Great Gatsby's Gold Coast, which runs on December 4th through December 6th. If you're interested in that bus trip, please give us a call at 610-375-4375 to book your seat on that trip. And in January, we also have the Poe and the B&O on Thursday, January 19th, and that will be with Charlie Adams visiting Baltimore City and the gravesite of Edgar Allan Poe.
Now we're coming to the part of our program. We're going to introduce you to a special guest of ours, and that is Bradley K. Smith. You're going to be looking at an exhibit that Brad did for the Historical Society, curated actually, is the word, and it's talking about Berks County and its origins, its founding, and how it's evolved. And now I'd like to introduce you to a very special friend to the Berks History Center and a very talented curator, Bradley K. Smith. Brad, thanks for joining us.
You're very welcome. It's good to be here.
Great. Bradley installed our latest exhibit, the Building Berks exhibit, and it really is wonderful because it shows in detail and over the span of our 200 plus year history how Berks County was founded and how it evolved. And so with that, I'm going to turn the program over to Brad and let him tell you about this exhibit and what's so special in it. Brad, take it away.
We're standing in the Building Berks exhibit, which we recently opened at the Berks History Center. And this was a very interesting exhibit to curate, a lot of fun to curate. The exhibit really began when the museum director, Sime Bertolet, approached me and asked if I would be able to fill this gallery with an exhibit featuring some of the organization's artifact collections. The challenge was that the collections here are very, very diverse and very rich. So for me, it was initially a challenge to determine what I wanted to put in the exhibit. When I assembled the exhibit, I tried to focus on stories which were quintessentially Berks County. So for example, I discussed the iron industry and the Pennsylvania German story, which is a big part of the county. And I let the stories really guide the selection of the artifacts, and hopefully the artifacts really relate to the stories I'm attempting to tell here. We really also attempted to focus on people. There were many artifacts here with great stories about individuals who've contributed to our county's history, and we really tried to emphasize that as well. At the first part of the exhibit, we focused a little bit on the origins of Berks County. The county was formed in 1752, and a lot of people don't realize that Berks County was originally much, much larger. And one of the objects we have in the exhibit is a map from 1818. That's significant because Berks County's borders as we know them today were established only in 1811. So this map was printed only 7 years after modern Berks County took shape. But the county itself was formed in 1752. And one of the things we also focus on in the exhibit are some of the aspects of the early government and political operations of the county. We have a very early map showing the diagram of Reading, which Reading actually predates Berks County by several years, and it was Richard and Thomas Penn who laid out the community. When the county was formed several years later, Reading made perfect sense to serve as the county seat. Another really great artifact we appreciate quite a bit here is this date stone from the original Berks County Courthouse, which stood in the center in Penn Square of Reading. And you can see the date stone has a 1762 date and the initials of the three county commissioners at the time. Right above that date stone, we have a print showing the courthouse from which that date stone came. That was the original Berks County Courthouse built in 1762 and used until the 1840s, or actually till the 1830s, and it was demolished in 1841. Another interesting artifact we have here is a padlock from the first Berks County prison, which was built in 1770. The prison was torn down in 1911, and that lock is one of the few artifacts that remain to tell us the story of that first prison. The iron industry was a very important part of Berks County. We were home to numerous iron furnaces and foundries and forges, and iron was a very big part of the early economy of Berks County. These artifacts are especially unique to Berks County because they are stove plates from what were known as jam stoves or five-plate stoves. This is a very unique design used exclusively or almost exclusively by the Pennsylvania Germans. A jam stove adjacent to the fireplace, they could put hot coals into the stove, the plates would heat up, and that would keep the entire room warm. So there was not actually a fire burning inside the stove as much as you had the hot coals from the adjacent fireplace being occasionally shoveled into the jam stove. There was no flue for smoke to go out of as a result. So these were literally just an iron box, but quite ingenious and a very effective heating method for about 50 years, from about the 1720s to the 1770s. These were very commonly used in this area. These two were both made in Berks County. The one on the left is particularly interesting because it dates to 1726, making it very old. One of the oldest objects, in fact, in this exhibit. It was made at the Colebrookdale furnace, which was Berks County's first iron producer. The stove on the right, or the stove plate on the right, was made in 1760 at the Berkshire furnace, which is in South Heidelberg Township, or was in South Heidelberg Township. And is interesting because the stove plate was made in the area, but it was found in a home in Berks County. And in fact, the entire stove was found, and we have that entire stove intact. This is just one plate from that stove. In this case, we have artifacts representing Berks County's agricultural heritage. Agriculture was a very big part of the early economy, and it continues to be an important part of Berks County's economy. The first item we have in the case is a threshing flail used for threshing grain. That would have been used in a barn where literally you would have beaten the grain to separate the grains. Behind that, we have a hatchel, which was used to separate, clean, and straighten flax fibers. And what's really interesting about that one is we know that it was made by John Philippi Jr. of Reading, because it's dated J.P. 1801. And that's typical of something we really strove for in this exhibit, in that we sought artifacts where we know who made them, we know who used them as much as possible, so we could tell stories of real people. To the left of the hatchel, we have a stencil that would have been used for inscribing or stenciling barrels containing flour. This was used by a fellow named Elias Raber, who had a mill in Burnville area at about the turn of the 20th century. This drawing is one of several we have at the Berks History Center, completed by an artist named Ferdinand Brader. Ferdinand Brader was an immigrant from Switzerland who came to Berks County and in the 1880s traveled around the countryside drawing Berks County farms. And what are so wonderful about Ferdinand Brader's work is he was extremely meticulous. You can look at a Brader drawing and see very intricate details of architecture. You can see what livestock was on each farm. You can see even the details of the clothing worn by the people. One of the things I enjoy pointing out is that every Brader drawing seems to have several individuals, suggesting that the individuals whose farms he was drawing, wanted to be a part of those. We have one on display in the exhibit and several others in storage, and we're interested in maybe rotating these periodically so that visitors can get a glimpse of some of the different drawings we have by Brader. One of the most influential ethnic groups in Berks County were the Pennsylvania Germans. Pennsylvania Germans, for the most part, came from the southwest region of what is today Germany, from the Rhine River Valley. And with them, they brought unique decorative arts, food, culture, language, traditions. One of the Pennsylvania German traditions that was very common in this region was the giving of blanket chests. Blanket chests, such as this one, were given to boys and girls when they were in their early teen years. And particularly in the 18th century, blanket chests were very, very beautifully decorated with painted flowers and other decorations. This particular blanket chest dates to 1774. Another form of Pennsylvania German artwork is the show towel. These show towels, like the one you see here, were often done by Mennonite artists, and very common in the mid-19th century. Very beautifully decorated, they would have hung on a door. These were not towels that were used, and you can see with this one, it was made in 1848 for Johannes Whitmer. We also have, at the Berks History Center, a very large collection of Frochter, and we have different examples of Frochter, all with documented history of being made by Berks County artists. Berks County is also very well known for hex signs or barn stars. And one of the unique artifacts which we borrowed for this exhibit is this barn star, which was from a barn in Exeter Township and dates to 1868. Which makes it one of the earliest painted barn stars which I'm aware of. We also wanted to focus on some of the other ethnic groups that were important in Berks County, both in the 18th, 19th, and 20th centuries. And one of the very significant groups in the county's early history were the English Quakers, who were settling in places like Exeter Township and other regions. So to tell that story, we included this marriage certificate from a Quaker wedding that occurred in 1803 between Ellis Lee of Exeter Township and Mary Penrose of Maiden Creek Township. And it's a unique document because everyone in attendance at the wedding signed the certificate. We also have next to that a table from the Quaker Meeting House or the Friends Meeting House that was in Robeson Township in Berks County. That was founded in 1743 and used until the 1870s. In the 19th century, our nation underwent a transformation from a more agrarian society to a more industrial society. A lot of people know of this era as the Industrial Revolution. And the Industrial Revolution had a very big impact on Berks County, and in particular, the city of Reading. Reading became really an industrial powerhouse, and a lot of people don't appreciate, don't realize just how prolific manufacturing in Reading and the surrounding area really was. For example, Reading Hardware Company was for several decades one of the leading suppliers of hardware in the entire nation. And here we have a lock from Reading Hardware Company. At its peak, they had 1,500 employees producing hardware every day. Reading was also home to beer manufacturing and pretzel baking, cigar making, and candy. A lot of people have heard of Luden's cough drops. Luden's was a candy company from Reading, and we have in the exhibit a candy mold from the original Luden's factory. Railroading was an important part of Berks County's history. There were several railroads who had tracks in the county, but by far the most influential, the most pervasive, was the Reading Railroad. The Reading Railroad had track going to many communities in Berks County, but they're probably most important because of the fact that they had a very large shop complex in the city. At the Reading shops, the Reading Railroad could fix and repair and even build from scratch locomotives. They could repair cars, and it was just a hub of tremendous activity. Reading was an important center of printing in the late 1700s and early 1800s. And in particular, it was important for German language printing. One of the most important things printed in Reading was the German language newspaper, the Reading Adler, or Reading Eagle, which was published from 1797 to 1913, making it one of the longest lived German newspapers in the nation. Reading was also the place from which the first German language Bible outside of Philadelphia was printed. And we have a copy of one of those Bibles printed in 1805 by a man named Gottlieb Jungmann. In this case, we have products made by Berks County artisans. And we call this section our cottage industry section because these are products made by people working out of their homes and small workshops. Everything in this case is unique because we know exactly who made it, where they made it, and when they made it. For example, in the lower left, we have something called a shoemaker's last, L-A-S-T. And this one was used by a man named Samuel Feaster. And what's really neat about that is it has a date, it has his name and date on it, and the date is 1840. In 1840, Feaster was only 20 years old, and thus he was really just starting out in the trade of shoemaking. What's interesting, though, is that he remained a shoemaker for the rest of his career, and 50 years later, he was still making shoes in Berks County. One of the things that is often overlooked is the fact that Native Americans were living in what is today Berks County for thousands of years prior to the arrival of Europeans. And we spent a little bit of time talking about that in the Building Berks exhibit. And one of the unique artifacts we have included is a spear point which was found in Berks County in Caernarvon Township. It was actually found in 1800, but we had archaeologists look at that spear point and they estimated that it is 9,000 years old. These panels are quite interesting. They're from the original Bern Reformed Church in Bern Township, dating to 1756. You see the panel on the right is missing a portion of it, of its left side, but the date 1756 is very clearly visible. That's interesting when you consider that Berks County is only about 3 years old when those date panels were made. Below that, we have an assembly of objects from Berks County's churches. And we use this case to discuss the importance of church and religion in the early history of Berks County. We have a combination of sheet music and offering baskets, communion cup, and other objects. The Moravian Church had a presence in Oley Township in the early years of Berks County, and in fact they operated a boarding school in Oley. This door is from that original school building, which was built in 1748, and it's all that survives of the boarding school. I thank you for joining me today on this tour of the Building Berks exhibit here at the Berks History Center. It's really been a lot of fun to assemble this exhibit and to share it with our visitors. If you've not been to the Berks History Center recently, we encourage you to come out and see what's new here and visit the exhibit.
Well, I'd like to thank Brad for a great exhibit and for joining us on this evening's program. The history of Berks County is a long one and it is unique. You can all be very proud that we are a part of this community. I would also like to thank Alexis Campbell for joining me on the show this evening, and I'd like to thank you for watching, and I encourage you to watch us on our next program, as well as going to the BCTV website to watch archived shows online. From all of us at the Berks History Center, I would like to wish you, our audience, a very safe, healthy, and happy holidays, and a prosperous New Year in 2017. Thanks for joining us, and we'll see you in 2017.
Winter brings cold temperatures and high costs for natural gas and home heating fuel. That is why the federal government provides block grant funds for Pennsylvania.